heard you could use some company. I have a chess set. Would you care for a little game? Nice room you have. Do you mind if I pull up a chair? Okay, great. Thanks. I also got us a little drink. So, a little birdie told me that he might be feeling a little stressed, maybe not getting your sleep. Someone to talk to and play a little game with, so I just grabbed my chess set and I thought maybe we could just mess around a little bit and have a little chat. Oh, wait, there's one more thing. Shh, gotta promise not to say anything. Sneak out and get one of these. I thought that we could take a look at this and give it a little review, so to speak. They always think I'm out getting water. So, I have that. Thank you. 4% ABV. So this should help cure our, wash away our stress for a little while at least, don't you think? I would give this easy 4 stars. I said, I just thought that set up here. So why don't we talk a little bit. some others. I think there's a Flash TV show coming out. I'm not too sure. And it was good to see in Guardians of the Galaxy, Merrill from The Walking Dead. I don't know his name offhand. Humanoid. Yeah. He played, oh, and of course, Thanos. That was awesome. I hope they do something with Thanos. I really love those larger than life, quote unquote, bad guys. Thanos. Side, you know. So that was cool. Check. Oh wait. Cells sometimes are checked out, so to speak. So it sometimes takes a lot of effort to rev them up again. This is pretty much my second job, but I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way. So besides Guardians of the Galaxy, have you seen anything else? I'm not sure if you saw that or not, but saw Planet of the Apes, Rise of the Planet. No, sorry. Yes, I did see Rise of the Planet of the Apes. I rented it through Netflix. Thought I could get my son to watch it with me, but it was too scary. It's funny. Planet of the Apes. it's fiction. Just like Guardians of the Galaxy. But the way that Planet of the Apes, Rise of the Planet of the Apes was portrayed, it's almost more realistic. Guardians of the Galaxy, you know, was fake, but they're both fake. But to a 7-year-old kid, he probably knows they're both fake, but one is just more realistic. So he couldn't watch Rise, because I wanted to have him watch Rise and then take him to see Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. But there was some scenes that were too intense during Rise. But Rise of the Planet of the Apes was good. There was some corny parts, like when the neighbor was like running down the street away from Caesar, that was like, you know, whatever. But for the most part, Rise was good. And I love this retelling of the Planet of the Apes. I think it's a great retelling of the, I'm not sure if it was ever a book, I don't remember offhand, or at all, not offhand, at all. I grew up watching the TV show and the movies, and I love them. That was my first, I think, introduction to anything somewhat post-apocalyptic, and I fell in love with the movies when they're going through the old subway. I love that. What, I want to have a discussion. Me and you, we should talk sometime. I want to talk about our attraction for the post-apocalyptic. There was a viewer who suggested that to have a vlog. We just talk about that, and that's something I definitely want to explore, our fascination with the post-apocalyptic. And I have some of my own thoughts, but we'll save that for another time. So, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes was just flat out awesome. It was intense, it was emotional, it was great, and very realistic. How they told about how the apes evolved and could speak, and Caesar was, the voice acting for Caesar was great. Xbox, I think. But they offer a lot of, they'll keep you up to date on deals. Even Target offers $5 Blu-ray deals, though they don't really change that selection. So many just, a lot of musicians as well. But Geiger's work and his contribution to the Alien film and Ridley Scott, Alien 1 is a great horror, suspenseful horror film. That's just great. That one scene when the mechanic is looking for the cat and there's the dripping water. Hearts, Chuck Berry, 45s, Johnny B. Good. Johnny B. Good. I remember winning at a small little fair at an elementary school. Sticks, Mr. Arigato, single. I played that over and over. I loved that song. Don Arigato, Mr. Arigato. The first couple of albums that I purchased, I remember back when I was about 10 years old, Michael Jackson's Thriller came out. Wow, what an amazing album from start to finish. Let me see, besides Thriller, we got I'm Bad, right? What the heck was on that? I actually purchased that album at a flea market last year and mailed it to Airlight. She's another ASM artist and she lives in the Ukraine. And I sent it to her because I know she loved Michael Jackson. I was like, you know what? I got this for like $5 at the flea market, $10 tops. Here you go. You know, that's a great album, Billie Jean. Man, I can't remember all the. Geez, I should know all the tracks on the album. I just can't. But love Thriller. I remember purchasing Van Halen's 1984. Another great album. And that was around 5th grade is when I began to explore my musical interests and I found out about music myself personally. There was MTV, that was new, that was great. I think that's why a lot of folks love the 80s, because MTV music videos for a large part of it. And then I found out about heavy metal. I was at a high school friend of mine's house when I was about 16 or 17. And we were looking at this. Back then, in the mail, you would get these. In the mail, these. I don't know how to describe. This little. Record companies, record publishing companies, you would get these little pamphlets and you could check off like 6-8 cassettes. I don't think it was CDs now. I don't remember. For the price of one, and you would give them, you write your address on it. And they would send it to you, and you would never have to send them any money or anything. It was like a, you know, and you could get away with these free initial CDs, but you couldn't do it again because they already have your address. So if you try to do it again, I don't think they would send anything to you because they already had you as sending the initial, you know, they're hoping to get you to subscribe. You get like a CD every month. Or whatever. I remember taking advantage of that as a teen. But I remember seeing Metallica for the first time, because Metallica was not on MTV. This was like 1986, 87. And somehow I think I listened to Ride the Lightning. I don't know if how I purchased it or whatever. I was just floored. Whoa, what is this heavy, badass music? It's just so, speaks to me. It's angsty. It's just what I have inside, because I was a shy kid. And some other things. I don't even know whose turn it is at this point. Let's see, I think I moved my there so you can my bishop because you'd be in check. I would be in check. I can't take your bishop because I would be in check from your knight to here. So, I just have to move. Here. So, I think one of my first loves was Metallica, Ride to Lightning. Just awesome album. And then from there, my interest in heavy metal just exploded. You know, I found out about Megadeth, Slayer. I found about Merciful Fate and King Diamond. Love that guy. Just another amazing artist. And then I started looking for obscure heavy metal bands like Fate's Warning, Death Row, Holy Terror, Nuclear Assault. You know, obscure heavy metal bands. I could say I listen to this that no one else listens to because there's something to be said about finding unique artists, whether it's writers or bands that not too many people listen to. It's almost like it's like I don't know how to describe it. There's a lot of folks, I'm not sure if you're like that, but I don't like to do what everybody else is doing. I like to do my own thing or find a unique individual and support them. But yeah, there's a lot of, my interest in heavy metal just took off because it was just high school. I was a shy kid, I had a lot of angst. Going through a lot of stuff, and heavy metal was such an outlet. Son, even so, I think this was before 2007. and she threw down some fat beatboxing. I've been a fan of hers ever since. And so if you get a chance, check out Butterscotch Music. She has a YouTube channel. And I'm not sure if she has a website. So aside from her, I like Amethystium. That's an ambient electronic band. I'm not sure if it's a one-man band. But that's also a link in the video description to I love every album. Great, relaxing, atmospheric, chill, beautiful, peaceful, ambient electronic music. Some of the best I've ever heard. I like Tori Amos, but my iPhone has Sullen, Carnival, Metallica, Amethystium, Gojira. Love Gojira. I think Gojira is what is the best metal band, right next to Tool. You know, Gojira to me is like today's Metallica for me. That's how I would put them. Great lyrics, great technical musicians, powering riffs, just great stuff, and they're somewhat pro environment. Where are we at here? I don't even know at this point. I'm just gonna take your pawn. I think you took one of mine, so. Kid Rock. Yes, I was a Kid Rock fan before he went country. So Devil Without a Cause, great album. After that, just like Metallica. After Justice for All, Black album is okay. That's more rock. Justice for All, Master, Ride the Lightning. That's really the big three for me. Kill 'Em All is okay. Megadeth is okay. Megadeth to me has one or two good songs per album, and then the rest is kind of weak. And that's no offense to any of you who are huge Megadeth fans. That's just my opinion. Do I like besides just heavy metal? Who else? Oh, Smashing Pumpkins. I think Billy Corgan is a very smart individual. Amazing, talented individual. And I have the double album on my Melancholy and Infinite Sadness. That's on my iPhone. That's a phenomenal album. Who else? Who else is on my iPhone? Tesseract. Until I liked Tesseract, just found out about them, and then the lead vocalist and the band split up. That's a shame because I really liked his vocals. But my knight here to threaten your queen. Well then, your pawn. That was a bad move for me. But this is just to mess around. check over here. I'm not even paying attention. I'm in check right here. You have me in check. How did I? Oh, you know what? No, I'm sorry. You don't. I knocked over my king. And change.